As your project grows, eventually you need to divide the code base into modules. There are different ways to make modules in JavaScript. Let me show you this little example. We have a function that is called Fibonacci Hello. It takes a name and a number as parameters, computes a Fibonacci number, and then outputs the name together with the input number and the Fibonacci number. And there is also another function which is called from inside Fibonacci Hello, which is Fibonacci. And this Fibonacci function actually computes the Fibonacci number. Let us see how it works. I have created a special HTML file for testing. Here in this script tag, I include the generated code. And in this script tag, I call the Fibonacci hello function. I set Drakon as the name and 6 as the number. Let us run and see what happens. See, we have this output string just as we expected. We have the Drakon, we have the input number, and we have the Fibonacci number for 6. The problem with this code is that all these functions are in the global scope. Let's open the sources. See, this is the generated JavaScript file. And we have functions Fibonacci and Fibonacci hello. And these functions, they pollute the global scope. One way to make modules in JavaScript is called immediately invoked function expressions, or IIFEs. IIFEs wrap code in a function which is called only once and it does not have a name. Let me show you. I open the properties of the module and change the module format to immediately invoked function expression. I save the properties. And then I build it again. Let me see what we have here in the generated file. See, this is the beginning of the expression, and this is the end. Let's see what we have in the console. We have an error, and that is because our IIFE did not put anything in the global scope. So we have to explicitly do that. If we want to export, for example, Fibonacci hello function, we need to explicitly put it in some global object, for example, in window. Let us do this. I open the properties of the module and then change the footer variable. Here, we take this window global object and then we save this function as a property. I save the properties and I regenerate the module. Let us see if we get it here. Right. Drakon.Tech has added this line that saves this function as a property of the window object. Now it should work. Yes, we see this in the console output. Another way to make a module in JavaScript is CommonJS. CommonJS is usually used in Node.js. So I set the properties and in CommonJS, we need to mark functions that we want to be exported. To do this, we open the parameters icon and add the export keyword explicitly here at the top. Now, Let me generate the module and see what we have here in the sources. Okay, we need to remove this line. Let us remove the footer. Again, save. And then build the module. Here we see a typical CommonJS boilerplate. We add an empty exports object to the global module, and then we add the exported function as a property to the exports object. Another way to make a module in JavaScript is a factory function. And this factory function method is usually used in browsers. Let me show you. I change the module format to factory, and then I save the properties. I build the module, and let's see what we have here. Here, Drakon.Tech has created a function called tutorial10, just like our file is called. And in this function, it creates an empty object module. In the end of the function, this module object is returned. But before it is returned, Drakon.Tech puts the exported functions here in this module object as properties. So, in other words, this function creates a module object, saves the exported functions in it, and returns it. For this to work, I need to modify the client code. I need to add a line that creates the module. And then I need to call a method on this module object. Let us reload the page. What do we have here? Again, the same output as before. We have full control over how modules get instantiated and in which order. Another way to organize modules in JavaScript is ECMAScript 6 modules or ES6 modules. Let me show you. I change the module format to ES6 and then save the properties. I build the module and let us see what we have here in the generated code. Now all the boilerplate is gone, but we can see that Drakon.Tech has added this export keyword before the function definition. We need to modify the client code again. First, we need to add type equals module for this to work. Then we need to get rid of this line. And then we need to import the module. Import as tutorial. And here we put the URL of our generated module. Now I can delete the first script tag and save it. Let's run it. See, it works again. Drakon.Tech allows us to choose the appropriate module format for our JavaScript modules.